Ever heard the saying, curiosity killed the cat? Well, I stumbled across a featured game on itch.io, conveniently named Project Cat. In Project Cat, Paper Lily, Cat might have just been a bit too curious, but don't worry, her curiosity doesn't kill her. Or does it? Paper Lily Prologue is really unique, and I mean that in the best way possible. And what I mean by that is that graphically, you really wouldn't think there's any possible way that this is a horror game. And boy was I wrong. The developers were able to create a thrilling, suspenseful game despite the way it looks. They were able to nail down the music and sounds to match the tone of the story. The story was pretty well executed and honestly, this really felt like a webtoon that was turned into a game. The cutscenes, while not animated, really filled in those gaps that you wouldn't really be able to execute in a pixelated game. And honestly, I would give this a solid 4 out of 5. Now, the creators did really well, but that doesn't mean that this game was perfect. And I never came into the expectations that this game would actually be perfect, keep in mind. So there were some grammatical issues that they had to work on, maybe even clean up the storytelling just a tiny bit. Possibly adding in some voiceovers I think would really transform this game. Or, you know, maybe not. Let me know if you think that's even necessary. Once you play this game, of course. Wait, but really quick. If you're enjoying this video so far, can we get this channel to 10 subs, please? We're just one sub away, and I would really appreciate that. But if that's way too much to ask for, and I know that's a lot to commit to, if you can, hit the like button. So this video is recommended to others, and so they can also enjoy this game. Okay, so with that criticism aside, it's not really even that much, considering this game was developed by only a team of two, and it's basically just the introduction to the full game. I honestly believe that this game has a lot of potential. So let's go ahead and take a step back and go back to praising this game a little bit more, because I haven't really been this excited about a game I played in a very long time. If this had just been a simple narrative driven game where you listen to what's going on and then something happens and, you know, basically a linear driven story, I think I would have just been as satisfied as I am right now. But Paper Lily is so much more than that. It's very RPG-like, and just like most RPGs, everything was interactable. You had objectives, and you'd had to solve puzzles to complete your objectives. They weren't extremely complicated puzzles, but they were still puzzles. At one point, you even had to rearrange a desk in each classroom, and the two developers on this team could have easily just taken a quick shortcut by doing a jump cut, interact with the desk, click yes, and it's all done for you. But they didn't cheap out on this. They went above and beyond and added a little minigame where you push the desk into its designated spots. Again, this puzzle wasn't complicated in any way, but it really kept you immersed with the game. And I even messed up a few times and had to reset because I was rushing things. So I know I'm bouncing around a little bit, but I wanted to touch back on the art and the story of this game. I mentioned earlier this felt like a webtoon that was turned into a game. I know this game is still currently in development, but I wouldn't be mad if it was actually turned into a webtoon. The devs really set themselves up to be able to make this into a pretty successful one in my opinion. The art style is already there. I'm very positive that it already has its story down. And to be honest, it's basically styled like most webtoons. So if the devs are watching this, maybe consider getting into webtoons while you're at it. Or, you know, of course, at least if your team has the capacity to handle that extra workload. Anyways, so one final thought. While playing, I wanted to make sure I interacted with all interactables so I didn't miss a single thing. Well, it turns out, I actually missed more than just one thing. I actually missed 7 things. Now, if you're just like me, and when I found this out, you're probably saying, dang, that's a lot. So while I was looking to see what others thought about this game, I came across a video that showed that there are 8 possible endings. And honestly, when I saw this, I was curious. But at the same time, it also made me appreciate this game a lot more. To think that the dev team, comprised of 2 people, mind you, were able to create 8 possible endings on a demo of their not full game yet, where they made this prologue a standalone game on its own, is quite impressive. Anyways, so thank you all for watching and listening to my thoughts on Project Cat Paper Lily. Make sure you play this game, and I forgot to mention this earlier, but it's completely free on itch.io. But I would highly recommend donating to the team if you liked it. I'm sure it'll help their development process into the full game version of this. And remember, curiosity killed the cat.